Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about what are the methods of preparation of alkenes, and we have did that also. And now we are going to study about what are the physical properties of alkene. So let us check that out. Now we are dealing with the physical properties of alkenes, and what are the physical properties of alkene? Let us start with that. So talking about the first one, that is the first three alkenes are gases, and talking about the first three alkenes, that is it would be ethene, propene and butene. So these are basically present in a gaseous form, but the next few members are present in a liquid phase and the other higher members are present in a solid phase. So this is similar to that of the earlier one that we have studied about in alkanes, because in alkanes also we have studied the physical properties, and in that we have got to know that the lower members of alkanes are basically present in a gaseous form, while the higher alkanes are basically present in the, that is, solid form. So it is very similar to that of the property of the alkane. Talking about the next one, ethene, or we could say it as ethylene in terms of a common name. So ethylene is a colorless gas with a sticky sweet odor. So it has a odor, basically odor is nothing but as a smell, we know that it has a very sticky sweet odor, while the others are basically colorless as well as odorless. So that was the property of the ethene itself. And talking about the next one, that is this all alkenes are basically soluble in organic solvents like benzene, ether, etc. The reason behind that is because hydrocarbon, when we are talking about alkenes are basically the hydrocarbon, or we could say it as an organic compounds, and these organic compounds are very, very much easily soluble in organic solvents only, like benzene, or we could say it as ether. So that's the reason that these are very easily, or we could say that they are soluble in the organic solvents. But talking about the inorganic solvent, or we could say as a polar solvent like that of water, so therefore they are not soluble in water, because water is basically polar in nature. And while talking about the hydrocarbons, hydrocarbons are non-polar in nature, while benzene is also a non-polar. So as we know a concept that polar dissolves polar and non-polar dissolves non-polar, so that's the reason that they are not soluble in water, but yes, they are soluble in organic solvents like benzene, which are basically non-polar. So the boiling point of alkenes increases with increase in molecular mass. So this is very similar that we have did earlier also. As you know that if the molecular mass will go on increasing, and that is the reason that more energy has been required to boil that particular alkene. So if the number of carbon goes on exceeding, then obviously that the boiling point of that alkene will also be increased. And that's the reason we have seen in alkanes also, in that also we have got to know. And now talking about alkenes with basically branching have lower boiling point. So this is very similar to the alkanes that we have did in our previous chapter. So in that case, what we have got to know that suppose if we have an alkane, and if it is in a straight chain and it doesn't consist of a branching, so in that case what happens is more surface area is being present over there, and that's the reason that that alkane can form a kind of intermolecular force with the other kind of alkanes, and that's the reason more temperature is being required to boil that particular alkane. So similarly here also, when we are talking about the branching, so whenever an alkane, a particular hydrocarbon having a particular number of carbon, and that is an alkene, and if it is in a branching form, then what will happen is the surface area will decrease, and that's the reason that there will be no that is a force of interaction that much compared to that of a straight chain alkene. So that's the reason that no more temperature is been required, or no more energy is been required, so as to boil that particular alkene, and hence the branching alkenes have lower boiling point. So this is what we have studied about the physical properties of alkene. But let me tell you, there are other physical properties that are also that I'm going to talk about. So starting with this one. In terms of alkene, we know that alkenes are the one which consist of carbon-carbon double bond in the hydrocarbon. So suppose if I'm mentioning about this one, which consists of carbon-carbon double bond, and if all, suppose if this valencies are been fulfilled by the hydrogen atoms, as you could see over here. So this four are the hydrogen atoms that have been attached to the carbon atom over here. So now talking about the bonds, as we could see that there are two bonds between the carbon and carbon, and among which one of the bond will be strong and one of the bond will be weak. So that makes us to understand that one of the bond would be a sigma bond, while one of the bond would be a pi bond. So while observing that carbon-carbon double bond is present between between two carbon atoms in alkenes. So while talking about the bond enthalpy is also we know, and let me just revise it. So let me just talk it about this again. That is, when we are talking about carbon-carbon bond or any kind of bond between the two atoms, and the energy required to break that bond is known as basically bond enthalpy. So in here case also, we could see that there is basically two bonds between these two carbon atoms. So if I suggest that if we have an alkane which consists of only one bond between carbon and carbon, so the energy that has been required to break this bond, suppose if this would be, suppose I would call it as H1. So therefore, when it comes to the bond enthalpy of the alkene, then this should be basically, that is 2 times of H1. But is this true? No, this is not true. The reason behind that is the energy required to break this bond is not the double of the energy that has been required to break the carbon-carbon single bond. The reason behind that is because of the strong bond and weak bond. If this two bond would have been the sigma bond itself, then the energy would have been spent the twice of that of the energy required to bring the carbon-carbon single bond in alkane. But in this case, what we have got to know that one bond is basically a strong bond known as a sigma bond, which is formed because of the head-on collision of the p orbital of carbon, while one of which consists of a pi, which is known as pi bond, and that has been obtained or that has been formed due to the overlapping of the p orbitals, and that also in a lateral manner. So that is the reason that one of would be the weak bond and one would be the strong bond. So that is the reason that we don't have to spend exactly twice the energy so as to break the bond. So in this case, what we have got to know that the energy that has been required to break the double bonds between the carbon and carbon is less than the double of that of the bond enthalpy of carbon and carbon in an alkane. So less energy has been required to break this bond compared to that of the double of, that is delta H1, if you talk in that manner. So this was the thing that I had explained about, and even this comes in the physical property, that is we don't have to spend exactly the double energy so as to break the bond. We have to spend at least less energy than the double, than that of the carbon-carbon single bond to break the bond. So now this is what we have studied about, and let me talk about the bond angles. So what would be basically the bond angles between here? So basically talking about this carbon atom that is in alkene, the both the carbon atoms are obeying the hybridization or forming the hybridization, which we know as sp2 hybridization. So these carbons are basically showcasing sp2 hybridization. That's the reason the bond angle between, as we could see over here, I could mention over here, that is the bond angle between this carbon and carbon and this carbon and hydrogen, it would be basically 120 degrees. So because of the carbon is exhibiting sp2 hybridization in alkene, and that's the reason 120 is the bond angle that we could observe over here. So this were the some physical properties that I wanted to showcase about the alkenes, and we have also studied about more about the physical, the nature and of alkenes, that is whether they are colorless or whether they are odorless, etc. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.